So today you've come on a day where I was prepping for Sports League. So Sports League's happening tomorrow, and it's coming live from in this building. But they've got loads of different things that are going on outside. So you'll probably see it at some point tomorrow. They're doing a five-a-side thing with Robbie Savage and some other footballer. And then people are taking penalties against Shay Given, who's like an old goalkeeper for 12 hours. Sounds dead good telly, doesn't it? So they'll be doing this for 12 hours out there. And they're going to be filming it inside kind of this studio block as well. But this whole kind of area is not the BBC's. It's not owned by the BBC. It's owned by a company called Peel's.
Music is a national network digital radio station, but Six Music is a little different because it's music based. It's got it in the title. So all of the presenters that work here are employed for their music knowledge. It's not just about being a personality. So if you're listening to Nick Grimshaw on Radio 1 or Chris Evans on Radio 2 and they're doing the breakfast shows, they don't get any say at all in the music that they're playing. They get told every day, that is your playlist, you have to play them in that order, you have to stick to this for various reasons, commercial reasons, demographic reasons, that kind of thing. No, is the person who drives the desk. There's nobody in the room to press buttons for presenters. They have to operate all of this equipment themselves. The middle screen that we can see in there, this is where all the music is kept, because of course there is no such thing as physical music in radio stations. There hasn't been for a long time. Mm-hmm. Everything is digitised, of course. And that's where it all comes from. That middle screen is a piece of software called Highlander. And think of it as a giant Spotify library or a giant iTunes library. There are millions and millions. When I say millions, I'm talking about 20 million tracks. The next screen along, that multicoloured one that you can see there, that's called a cart wall, and that's where all the jingles are kept. Again, these are personalised to each and an individual presenter because they all like to personalise their shows in different ways. Think about Chris Evans in the morning and all the different things he plays as he's presenting. So this one is currently lugged in for Marianne Hobbs. You might have heard of Marianne Hobbs. She's used to present on Radio 1 about 10 or 15 years ago. She does the breakfast show in here every weekday, Saturdays and Sundays. So her cart wall, her jingle's there. She's got air horn, she's got panda air horn. She's got Roots, Kendrick Drop. All of these things mean stuff to Marianne Hobbs. They don't mean anything to me and you. But as she's going along, she can press the right touch screen.
Press the button, it?
Just a touch screen, yeah, and it'll play. They're just little MP3 files that are loaded in there. It's called a cart wall because a long time ago, it was a wall. And you would get a cartridge and put it in and press play. And it was like an 8-track and it would play that jingle or that piece of music. Yeah. You take it out, you'd rewind it, and you'd put it and file it away in a filing cabinet again. Mm. So it's kept its title, but of course it's very different now. It's a touch screen. And then this screen here, the final one, it's called the BNCS, the Broadcast Network Communication System. That's the one that gets you live on air if you press the right buttons in the right order, so let's not do that, shall we? It will take control and put this studio live on air.
That would be scary.
It would be scary, yeah. But it's also the one that we can have lots of shortcuts to different... it links this studio up to potentially any other radio studio in the world, but also it has lots of shortcuts to any other BBC studio in the country. So we might have a guest on Stuart and Mark's show this afternoon. They're not here, they're in Radio Sheffield, for example. We want to get them on the show. They're not here, we get them into a studio in Sheffield. We just press the shortcut for Radio Sheffield up here. It's through an ISDN line, which is a very high quality telephone line. And it sounds like that person, that guest, is here with us in the studio. Now, this happens all the time in radio. If you listen to BBC Radio, it happens all of the time. And you might think, I don't know if you, but I'm always thinking, is that person in the studio? Or are they, especially if you're going to a weather report or the news report or a traffic and travel report, for the vast majority of the time, that person is not in the same studio as them. Might not even be in the same building, might not even be in the same city. So for every hour here, We do a quick 2 or 3 minute news bulletin on the hour for Six Music, but it's somebody in a studio in London that is dialing in to our studio here. Mm. This is here, this is a mixing desk. So if for Six Music, we have lots of live bands that come in, and the studio next door is bigger. It's about twice the size of this. And if you can see just through, if you get a glimpse, there is a drum kit in there, and there's a piano booth in there. Yeah, so most evenings a live band will come in for Mark Riley's show. Now, Mark Riley is sort of the John Peel of the BBC now. Mm. He is the person that discovers new bands and brings them in, and bands that aren't signed and all that kind of thing. Mm. And they'll set up in there. So when that happens, we mix the sound from in here. This is a big mixing desk that you might see at the back of a gig. Mm. And so your sound engineer will be mixing all the sound in here to make it sound good on the radio. You can't mix sound in the same room that a band is playing in, because all you can hear is that really loud drum kit in your ear, and you can't actually do what you need to do. So this is just a big mixing desk.
We don't just do music-based radio. I think I can say we're very good at doing radio dramas as well. So we're the only radio station, really, that does any sort of radio dramas. I know you can pick it up on loads of apps and iTunes and stuff like that, but do any of you listen to anything on radio? The Archers is probably our most famous radio drama. We've done it forever. We've done it for about 50, 60 years. It's been a long time that we've done it for. And that comes from a purpose-built studio that has it in Birmingham. So it has its own studio because they're always recording in there. But we do probably about 40, 50% of most radio dramas up in here in Salford. So we sometimes will do it in rooms very similar to this. Or we have our big audio kind of studio in the studio block as well, where if you've listened to any afternoon plays or anything over the past 6 years or so, chances are it's been recorded over in the building just next door. So radio drama is probably more popular now than it has been in a very long time. I think just for the reason you can download it and listen to it whenever you want to listen to it, rather than having to sit in front of the radio at the specific time to listen to something. Like with The Archers, it's, 15 minutes long. It's on every day. And then if you miss that, you've got the omnibus, which is still on the... Is it still on the Sundays? The Archers omnibus? Yeah. But then if you... You know, you can miss all of that and still listen to a week's worth when you're not around, or if you're going on a plane or something like that, you can download a lot of it. And there's also this misconception that radio drama's for an older generation of people, but it's just not at all. It's like a lot of people are listening to it now because you can get it whenever you want to get it. So that's one of the kind of one of the plus points of it. But we do spot effects as well. So these effects genuinely get used for all of our radio dramas. They're not done by the actors. They are just acting. So we have a studio manager who will do these effects. And if you close your eyes when I do some of these, especially this one, get you in the moment a little bit more than just watching me flap some gloves around. So just close your eyes and tell me what you think this sound effect might be. Say, birds, yeah, birds on the radio. So just, like I said before, we don't go outside for sound for radio drama. So if I'm walking down a gravel path, it's someone's job just to do the sound effects of this happening. And we do it on the spot rather than having the sound effects, because it then sounds a little bit different in every play rather than it being the same. And then if we are doing, if it's a bit fancy and someone's celebrating their 60th birthday, they've got themselves a nice little drink. Instead of champagne on the radio, we have... If you are eating on the radio and you're having a nice little steak dinner, you're eating cake or bananas because it's the quickest thing for you to chew and swallow. So you never eat nice food on the radio dramas either. And there's also, the more accents you can do on a radio drama, the more parts you might get as well. So if you're very good at doing voices, you might get 3 or 4 parts in the same radio drama. And at some point, it might be you playing all 3 characters in one scene, which becomes very confusing, because you either switch between doing each voice or have to record each of the lines separately and just... I imagine it's very strange if you have to have an argument with yourself.
And is this what you expected the studio to look like?
No.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah. Just look at all the lights above your head. These are the cameras that are on the floor. They're called pedestal cameras. All these are lights. So, if you haven't watched Match of the Day recently, or if you just want to see what Match of the Day looks like when it's on air, just have a look at my iPad here, just a still from Match of the Day. And you can see, you can sort of recognise it in front of you, what you can see, but what a difference, eh? What a difference it all makes. They are. So these big giant television screens, they're basically huge projectors. Those are big boxes. They're not flat, they go all the way back. They're very expensive. So for the rest of the week, when they're not being used, they get boxed over. They're not, they're huge projector screens. So they are...
Behind the
floor. They are, yeah. So right at the back of the boards. Back there. You can just see it's a big box and it's a projector in the back and it projects for us. It's blue on here. It looks like a blue studio. It's not. It's a white studio with blue light shining on it. For football focus, that'll be green. For final score, that will be yellow. So we get three live football shows from this studio every Saturday. And if you do watch all of those shows, I don't know if you've ever appreciated or ever thought about, are those different studios? Are they in the same studio? Lots of people think they are different studios, they're not. It's just different branding, different graphics, and a different colour system. The other thing that this room is very good at doing is projecting graphics. It's something called augmented reality. You've heard of virtual reality? So augmented reality is when you're mixing live television and graphics at the same time. And it's difficult to do on live television. It's very easy to do in post-production. You get the images, you overlay the graphics, you put them together. But live television, it's really hard. And all of the cameras have got little antennas on the top. So as they move around the space, it means the graphics move with them. Everything is working as one.
Are they radio controlled?
They're not.
Are they operated?
They're manually operated, yeah. In some of our studios here, in the breakfast studio and in the sports presentation studio, they're robotic. The last thing I'm just going to point out is the numbers in the room. It's a grid coordinate system. It's like a big game of battleships, all set to go in and out, the dock doors there, and it's just an easy way of putting sets back in the right place again. There's no such thing as saying this is the Mastermind studio or the Personal Sports studio. It's the same studio, it's next door. Today it's Blue Peter. Next week it's 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown for Channel 4. It's the same studio. So the sets have to go out and come in and out and come in all of the time. So to put them in the right place again is a whole grid coordinate system. So you don't want to build something and realise you've built it 10 feet to the left and you've got to take it all down and build it up again.